So here's a coronavirus story that starts like a lame joke. In late February, just before everything started shutting down, three virologists walk into a conference room.
It was one of the last days the three of us were allowed in a conference room together, actually, on campus. And, you know, we were just, you know, we're really lamenting the fact that here we go again, right?
The three of them, Nat, Ralph, and Mark, they're frustrated because they're staring down a very familiar situation. Nat says,
here comes another epidemic. Here comes another pandemic, as it turned out. And we don't have anything. You know, there's no drug ready.
He's talking about the SARS and MERS outbreaks. They were caused by coronaviruses a lot like this one. But all the research that followed never turned up a knockout coronavirus drug. One that could help us fight this new virus, but also the next one to appear.
Instead, we saw the scramble starting. We were scrambling ourselves, trying to create antiviral drugs in real time. And that's not how the drug development process works.
But there in the conference room, they hash out a different approach, one that could lead to more future-proof drugs. No more scrambling, no more reacting. It just meant flipping their virus-fighting strategy on its head.
But what we realized is you could turn that concept around. SARS-2 and MERS, right? So these are viruses that are in the same family, but there's still a lot of variation.
This is real-life Nat Mormon. He works at UNC Chapel Hill with colleagues Ralph Barrick and Mark Heise. We talked to Nat months after that day in the conference room, and he told us more about why SARS and MERS didn't give us a big leg up on COVID.
There's a lot of differences between those viruses in the sequence of their actual genomes and also in the sequences of the proteins that they encode.
Viruses are wildly diverse. They differ in their sizes and shapes, how they enter our cells, how they mature and replicate. The problem is, those things are all targets for drugs. A drug that targets a specific part of one might not work on another. Also, if that one part mutates, the drug could break.
It just takes one change to make that drug not work.
Now, some drugs can work on multiple viruses. Remdesivir is one that's currently in use against COVID. It messes up viral RNA replication, and in the lab, it looks to be effective against SARS, MERS, and COVID. The FDA has only authorized it for severe cases, and its effect is modest. Still, it's a start. But Nat's team is chasing a different strategy. They started a program called READY to take on new viral threats like this one. And instead of hunting around old viruses for new targets, they're looking at us.
What we realized is you could turn that concept around.
The idea is this. Viruses can't reproduce on their own. They need a host cell and the machinery inside to replicate and mature and spread. The trick is our machinery, our cells, can respond to drugs too.
So when a virus infects a cell, it turns on or turns up a lot of cellular processes. If you can reverse that change back to the level of activity that was present in the uninfected cell, you can inhibit the virus replication. And even if you don't completely stop it, you can give your immune system time to respond and help clear the virus.
It's an idea that could make a big difference if we can understand how this virus changes us.
So we're generating that data for SARS-2. Right now, what are those changes?
If it works, this approach could be future-proof in ways that others just aren't. Since these drugs focus on our cells, they're less dependent on the specific features of viruses. So mutations might be less of a problem. And the approach could be effective against viruses that don't exist yet. The next coronavirus might look or act very differently. But it might co-opt our cells in similar ways, so it might be vulnerable to the same drugs.
So the idea is to take that approach, use it in a proactive manner, to go ahead and develop those drugs now so that we have them ready on the shelf before the next epidemic or pandemic arrives.
Now, this is not a new idea. It's actually how lots of drugs work. If you have arthritis or high blood pressure or a headache, you can take drugs that work on your own cells. But Nat says antivirals that work this way have gotten more attention post-COVID. It's one of those ideas that could really go places.
Well, it's good to dream big. Our ultimate goal, you know, our aspirational goal would be to find a truly broad spectrum compound that would inhibit all these different families of viruses. Now, did we think that was the most likely outcome? No, but it's a good goal.
Nat's team isn't taking that big a swing. They're focused on coronaviruses, flaviviruses, and alphaviruses, three families with high pandemic potential. But what'll it take to make those big discoveries? Partly, that depends on whether there's interest in the research after this pandemic is over. Historically, that's been a struggle. Just look at SARS and MERS.
They were scary things. Everybody recognized the potential devastation they could cause, but they were contained. And, you know, people move on from those things. A non-virologist, if you remind them, will remember it happened. But the answer you typically hear is, yeah, but that wasn't really that big of a deal. Not realizing how close we really were to that being that big of a deal. Life moved on, and so did the funding and the interest.
Of course, COVID is that big a deal. So hopefully the next wave of research will be too. Hey everyone, as the pandemic grows and evolves, we want to hear from you about what kinds of COVID stories you're interested in. So let us know in the comments, and day to day to stay up to date, head over to theverge.com. Thanks for watching.